guys, it's Lisette here. I get a lot of questions about frizz and curly hair, and for the most part, I like frizz. Like, I have frizz right now, and I wear my hair in like this high ponytail puff, and the frizz I think looks cute. But whenever you wear your hair out and you do like a wash and go and you just want your hair to look super defined, I wanted to show you guys what I like to do with my hair. The method is called finger coiling, and you literally take a curl and you want to coil it around your finger, and that helps to reduce frizz. It helps to create like this perfect curl, and especially if you're using the right products, your hair can look amazing. So I just wanted to show you guys how I do the finger coiling method on my curly hair, just to see what it looks like. I typically only do the top section of my hair, like the bangs and, you know, this front sort of area, but I don't do my whole head. And I always wanted to know what my whole head looks like if I were to do it. So let's test that out and see how it looks. Let's get started. So let's pretend today is wash day. I like to use the Diva Curl No Poo and the One Condition from the Decadence line. I really like to use these on my hair because I find that the formula makes it so that my hair is not really dried out. I have my microfiber towel, and after getting out of the shower, I just like to put this around my neck, around my shoulders, and it's time to style. So for my leave-in conditioner, I'm using my Kinky Curly Knot today. As you can see, the Denman brush really helps to make the curls form and they clump together, and this is also really good for definition. So to start the process of finger coiling, I'm putting my hair in sections so that I can work with just a chunk of hair at a time. I always like to stick to gels or jellies or something that's really thick. So I'm using the Diva Curl Ultra Defining Gel. They also have a light one if you have maybe looser curls than me, but I really like this one, and I also like to switch this up with the Camille Rose Naturals Curl Maker. You guys have heard me talk about these two products all the time. I just like to stick with things that I know my hair works good with, so that's why I always like to use these two products. So for the finger coiling or the finger twirling, I just like to twirl the hair around my fingers, and it's really easy, it's really simple, but it's cool because it forces the curls to clump together and it makes just a perfectly formed curl. Like I mentioned before, I only like to do the top section on like a daily, weekly basis or whenever I'm styling my hair. But for this video, I wanted to do my whole entire head just to be able to see what it looks like. Especially in my bangs, you can see how defined the curls are, and you can just see that there's individual curls there. I always like to smooth my edges just on the side. It's just what I always like to do before I finger twirl that side, and then I'm just going to do the same method. And when I'm done, I'm just scrunching my hair to reinforce the curls, and now it's time for me to air dry. So this is the annoying part, air drying. I don't use a diffuser anymore on my hair. I basically stay like this. And even if I'm like going to Starbucks, I'll have this around my shoulders and I'll just be driving around. But you gotta do what you gotta do. Don't touch your hair. I like never touch it. I literally like, I walk like this, like a robot, and I don't move. Don't touch your hair. Don't make any sudden movements, and just leave the towel on your shoulders, but make sure that it's microfiber. So just be careful and just do something, chill out, and yeah. So this is about 2.5 hours later. My hair is looking crazy. The curls are really just clumped together, and that's not cute, so I'm not keeping it like that. Here I'm just gently separating my curls, and if there's any frizz from doing so, I'm just twirling, you know, the curl around my fingers so that I can create the curl again. You can separate as many as you like or as few as you like, but I like to add a little bit of volume, so I tried to separate as many as I could. So this is the final look. As you guys can see, my curls are super defined and they're perfectly like coiled together. That's hence the term finger coiling. My hair is a lot more flat and I don't have as much volume because all of the curls are sort of connected. Can you see the curls? There is no way to get rid of frizz 100%. Curly hair is going to have frizz, and that makes it, I think, a little bit more fun, and it adds some more volume, and you know, at least on me, super flat curly hair doesn't really look cute. So I like to add a little bit of volume, just try to make it a little bit more voluminous, you know. But as you can see, my curls are really super defined. You can like pinpoint each curl So I like to do this when I want more of a, you know, toned down curly haired look where it looks really put together and like, you know, the curls are really formed. So this is the final look. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and if you try this out, send me pictures, like tweet me pictures. You can put them on Instagram and tag me because I would love to see it. Of course, if you like this video, then please make sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you guys next time.